more than growing old. Scares me more than growing cold. Scares me more than being told. It's all on me, loss of victory. The sun's in my shine, and the clouds in my coffee. The thoughts in my mind, and it slowly consumes me. Just to sit around like this scares me more than anything in the world. Scares me more than anything in the world. Scares me more than anything in the world. Scares me more than
either vocal up or guitar down. So you decide. So you decide. Can I get an amen on that? Anybody back there? It's mostly just me and the sound guy. Yeah, more vocal. More vocal. And is it too loud? How are you guys feeling? Right?
Sounds good.
Okay.
Sounds
good. Sure.
head in the clouds, thinking only of you.
I can feel it already. I'm going to sit down because I can feel it. I just come out. I got so much rock and roll in me. I got so much, it's just useless. It's just useless. Nobody wants to go there anymore. I really don't pride myself on having a soul, but I'm going to attempt to bear my soul. It's not a thing I have, though, but we'll do the best we can. I think people like that now. They're sitting, they're listening. They want to do me a service of listening to my heartfelt confessional stories. Which is super girly, actually. You feel me? He's lived as long as he possibly can, given the circumstance. 'Cause he's protected himself from the world. He never gave it a chance. And he says, here in my security, I've put a limit on my self-potential and my possibility. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Walls and they never change. Everything's in its place. Her relationship's so neatly arranged, down to religion and race. And she says, here in my security, I don't make a move unless my friends approve. I do what's expected of me. As I grow older, and there's so much that I do not know, I'm drawn to those who are bolder and go where no one dared to go. And I sleep and I dream of the person I might have been, and I'll be free again. And I'll speak like someone who's been to the highest peaks, yeah, and back again. Dream fades away and I face the day, and then realize that there's got to be some hero in me. There's got to be some hero in me. There's got to be some hero in me.
the sparkle and he's lost the fire. But their future looks very dim, and I say, here in my security, I've simply let myself go. I've developed a codependency. And as I grow older, there's so many places that I've never been. Well, time's tapping my shoulder. I hope it's never too late to begin. And I sleep and I dream of the person I might have been. And I'm the freaking. And I speak like a someone who's been to the highest peaks. Whoa, and back again. And I swear that my grass is greener than anyone's till I believe again. And I wake and the dream fades away and I face the day. And then realize that there's got to be some hero in me. There's hero in you and in me. Though sometimes it's so hard to see. There's got to be some hero in me.
Yourselves are all ready. Okay, so the others. Save some money, get some records on your way out.
Yeah.
There's a Barbie booth out there.
Did you see it?
I'm charging $10. It's like, you know, like sometimes, you know, I get invited to go play somebody's first dance at their wedding. And it's a wonderful thing to have your songs mean something to, you know, a young couple embarking on the whole rest of their lives together. And they hire you, they send you out to their event, and you meet Grampy and Nana and all their just crazy relatives and stuff. Everybody flies in for a wedding, and there's me. And I just show up like this, and I'm like, okay, you know, win. Welcome them for their first dance, and then I just sing a song while they do that slow dance in the circle, that slow circle. I don't know why people, when they slow dance, they go around, they twirl. But in that twirling, it's a wonderful thing because I get to see like her singing the lyrics into his ear when she comes around, and she's crying and singing into his, and then he comes around, and he's singing into hers, and I'm like, a song of mine. And then I get a bottle of champagne, you know, I swipe a bottle of champagne. and then I make quick business over there at the photo booth that they bought with me and the bridesmaids. We're just like, everybody, pilot, how many can we get in here? And then I go, you know. But that Barbie box, it's so on trend. I mean, this guy has everything. So that just came out, and that's just, I have one. So, give it up to Factory, right? It's crazy.
No matter how hard I try to tell you, everything's gonna be alright. I know you thought that I could pull you through. Man, you see me as a hero, yeah. I only wished I saw it too, 'cause you believe in me. The reason I failed to see, and I believe in you. So much more than you could ever do. Now I'm feeling so downhearted, because I see that I've let you down. I must stand as tall as I am in your eyes. No more lying and chained and bound, yeah. No more will I question, yeah, what it is you see in me. If you see me as a someone, that's what I'm trying to be, yeah, 'cause you believe in me. Much more than you could ever do. When you're down and you're lonely, with no one at all, no one at all, don't worry, 'cause I'll be right there, right there, if you call, yeah. You believe in me.
Seen in a while. So Joey, where you at? Joe, Jersey Joe. There's a guy named Jersey Joe. Maybe he left already. And there's a woman named Jen. Jen, you here?
A little bit.
All right, what you want to hear?
Oh, God.
Get back to me.
I will.
Okay. She told me that she was concerned. All of it, you see, was quite curious to me. I thought from my past I had learned. Now everything now had changed. I wondered somehow, was it all prearranged? Supposed to do, and no matter how hard
but he suddenly seemed real to me. I thought a lot about how our lives would end up. I thought of every possibility. I thought prevention was better than cure. Now it's been 6 weeks, girl, and there ain't nothing for sure. Sometimes the lives that we choose, they ain't really the things that we're supposed to do. And no matter how hard we wish upon a star, it might not be in the cards for you. So maybe we should loosen up, cause sometimes life will interrupt.
These are songs from all the records of mine. So for the fan who has the records, you are on a deep dive into anything could come next. So it's like 30 years of material, and anything could come next. And this is a thing, what we're doing here is just like what I was doing in 1983, 84. Talent show at school, lunchroom, student center, Jeff in a corner. I'll pick a corner, I'll sing some songs, you do your homework. I'll pick a corner, I'll sing some songs, you do the pogo. Through the 90s, I'll pick a corner, I'll sing some songs, you mosh pit. I got some good pictures of the 90s, because, you know, I would basically, I'd be playing this material. I had a drummer and a bass player and another guitar player. And there's photos of, you know, somebody saw the side stage taking pictures of me singing out to a gymnasium of sneakers in the air. You're just like, wow, that's so cool. So, you know, everybody, you know, throughout the generations, I mean, my experience has been like, I sing these songs, these same songs, I stand in the same spot and watch how people have interpreted the same thing throughout these passings of time. And it's just wild. It's wild that, you know, in its most immediate saying, like a lot of the songs I'll do are from the 90s, and so in its most immediate period of connectedness, I should say, to the song was probably the least period of time when folks were this attentive. And now a million shows, a million miles, everyone is attentive, and I'm like, I'd love to tell you the origin story, but I've absolutely forgot it. Do you know what I mean? Or I've told it so many times that I'd like to feel that I'm not new 30 years in. I'd like to think that I don't have to retell the story, you know? That would be the best thing. So, like, when I go see bands, I go see drunken, incoherent, stumblebum Evan Dando. He doesn't tell you, he doesn't like reintroduce the song. Everybody just goes apeshit. Anyway. I know a place. place where I can go when I'm alone. And they go, fuck yeah, that's the one all night. And I'm like, he won't remember. He don't know where he's at. I played a gig, look, this is just matter of fact. Don't write about how I talked about it. I talk about a lot of people, but it don't matter because it's me talking. Like if I was an influencer, it might matter. I could affect their trajectory. But I cannot actually affect anyone's trajectory, so me talking shit on anyone is just more like just news reporting of matter-of-fact things that actually took place. So I remember doing a show, and it was me and him on the bill, and he got a ride there. I think he just got dropped off, and then I opened up, and then he didn't have a guitar. I was like, you know you're playing, right? So I had to watch his set because he had my guitar. I was like, I have to stay now. And, I'm just backstage, you know, getting so keyed up about it. And so, like, it matters so much to me. And I'm all keyed up and I'm drinking water and I've got tea and I'm, like, thinking it matters. And, you know, this guy's, like, in last week's. It was like, it goes good either way you slice it. You could pace upstairs and be like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, I can't wait, I can't wait, I can't, hope they like it, hope they like it, hope they like it. Or, hey. Like either way it worked, it was weird. I learned a lesson that night. Maybe I'm trying too hard. You'll see what I mean by trying too hard. And that they'd seen the truth. These men and women, young and old, who tried to mold my youth. They were only teaching me how to get through life, how to punch the clock and get a home and get a wife. They knew I was searching for things I've never found. Tried to break my mind by paddling my behind, all for the love of an innocent mind. But they were the blind, leading the blind, yeah, all for the love of molding young minds. But they were too kind.
Food for thought that never is tasted. Just just read the instructions and fill out the form, yeah. And whatever you do, my son, don't stray from the norm.
Upstairs, I got a little dressing room up there, and I saw a Kix poster, a really old vintage Kix poster, with Donnie Purnell on bass still. So that excited me, Hagerstown, Maryland people. Kix was a big group I used to go to see when I was a kid. I still go. It's their last show. They got a last show coming up. They're going to retire. They're going to wrap it up. Mixed emotions on that. It's been years. He's been here, and time just lingers, and no one knows. He's got eyes. He's got ears. His toes. His life of observation. Maybe one day he'll get to translate this information. For 20 years he hasn't spoken a word. He's been silent since the accident occurred. So many people taking tongues for granted, taking the truth, finding ways to slant it. I know a man who knew what to do, yeah. So many people go day in, day out, just dreaming of things they can bitch about. I know a man who knew what to do, yeah. It's a dream. For him it's real. And it never goes away. And it never will. He's in touch with what he feels, yeah. Oh, but he just can't say it. Maybe it's better still. This is a life of endless frustration. He's got his pride, he's not exempt from humiliation. He can't lift a finger to stop what's wrong. And he can't lift a leg to dance to a Beatles song. With so many people taking spines for granted, slithering squirm taking what they had. And it might be you. Yeah. 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 Anybody know? 21. Gotta be 21?
Yeah.
Gotta be 21. After that. Wonderful to be with you tonight. The worries of the world will subside. Your heart, open your mind, open up your arms and hold on tight. Burning my desire for you, all my dreams they are coming true. Yeah, now you're more to me, I'm more to us. There's more to living, much more I know, more to be. So glad that we are beyond the beginning. Beautiful, the starlight on your skin.
apart. And we got wounds we must mend. We both lost a partner. We both lost a friend.
Hill.
'Cause life ain't got no rules, but somehow I still care for those who love themselves even more than I care for myself. And though you bring me pain and sorrow,
maybe I carry that around with me. but I carry it around with me, and no one could save me from it. It was weird. You know, sometimes, you know, when somebody gets caught like in a turbine, you want to do something, but you're like, uh-uh. It was one of those. I'm like, come on, save me. And they're like, no, it's bloody over there. You keep at it. So then it got me in this mood. I was like, oh, yeah. Okay, fine. And I opened up the vault of Jeff Gaines' material that should never be performed in front of a group. But it felt really good. It feels good to write the songs in your heart or whatever, the songs in your spirit. Like some of the old beat poets or whatever, a lot of, you know, it's not always the healthiest sentiment, but they did the work, they put the work in, they put the pen to page and expressed it. So I can only really describe this song as Hank Williams' last limo ride. I don't know, he passed away on a ride from a gig to a gig. At least that's what the folk lore told me. And this is when he's in the back seat of the last transport from this gig to that gig, this is the song that was playing.
nothing I can do. Side by side, we're gonna finally get you on the mend until you love yourself again. I always thought of you just like a brother. When we were young, we tried out to the other. With motorcycles and girls, we were the kings of our little worlds. And but now you're falling apart. Step by step, you can't let you just waste away. Step by step, we're gonna get a little better every day by day. We're gonna finally get you on the mend till you love yourself again.
But you know, you never know how that goes. Sometimes people are like proud to have you, and then sometimes you'll be like, oh. I think I get the hint.
Go back.
I'll do anything. Get back in them then. But that's way better. It's like, it's I can see you now. That's so much better for me.
All throughout history, you made sure your conscience be clear. But there's two sides to every story. Here's what you don't want us to hear. That they once had harmony, and you could not understand how they could live so free. You drove them off of their land. Then you made laws to serve only you, and you laughed at their spiritual way. Are you deserving a praise and blame? For they'll never be the same. you deserving your praise or blame? For they'll never be the same. They once were royalty, but you could not measure their worth until you saw them like property. The salt from their sweat fed the earth. You shipped them away, they worked your newfound land. You stripped them and gave them new names. Are you deserving a praise or blame? For they'll never be the same. Are you deserving a praise or blame? For they'll never be the same. Had God-given grace, truly a gift to behold. But soon life's light leapt from their face. We're dark within your household. You made them take vows to serve and obey. You really must have been afraid. Are you deserving a praise or blame? the grand facade is so soon will burn without a noise.
appreciate it. Oh man, I'm just getting lost up in my world, my music world. I love it. So. Jump in my love car. Don't have to go very far. Just far enough to show you a thing or two.
Master. ask you where you are going. Nobody knows where you're from.
no tomorrow. I mean, you know, you're going to be right one day. And when you're right one day and there is no tomorrow for you two, you can wake up the next morning, splash the cold water in your face and be like, I gave it my all, every opportunity that I had to give it. And I can live with that. Ever since I was a child, I was having fun and running wild. But now I'm older and the world is growing colder. I hope I don't run out of time. Yeah. His name's Malcolm Holcomb or something like that. Anybody confirm that for me? Anybody know Malcolm Holcomb? No. Right, going once, going twice. No. He's a wonderful guy. Plays Sit Down. His name's Malcolm Holcomb. And I got to do a bunch of shows with him when I was over in Europe. And I love him. I love his breathing. Like he's worked, like he's kind of, his whole portrayal is this downtrodden mountain man, kind of woods dude. Like, he just comes out. He's super disheveled, which is my bag. I love it. And it ties in with the Evan Dando story, just add 35 more years. And it's just like this hobo guy that, like, that's like your first short-sighted impression, you know? And then he sits down and he just, like all these noises, all these like phlegmy noises become like his music. Like as he's singing, the note trails off and then it's just, and like at first you're like, that's so weird. But then you couldn't have the song without it. And he talks about his sud, like, you know, and I don't mean Southern upbringing. I mean, dirt floor, Appalachian country, like just country, but not like with a hat. They couldn't afford a hat. That country, like he's this real bluegrassy country folk. And to me, so he's got this song, he's talking about in his childhood, he had the shittiest Christmases. His dad was drunk, and it's just like somebody came in with a bucket of chicken. Merry Christmas, fried chicken. And you're like, what the fuck? These lyrics are so weird. And then you hear the whole story, you're like, man, he's just ripping it open. Anyway, so check him out. He's on YouTube. And he's like, you know, my archetype. My heroes are, all my heroes are nothing what is going on. Like, the stuff that I aspire to be has got nothing to do with Katie and Lionel Richie. You know, I know that a lot of people come to music by way of, you know, populace and what's hot now and new and on trend. And I'm still interested and motivated only by just so many little outcasty people. Because, you know, when I had like a couple of bucks, I'd go to the record store. I'd go to this record store. And there's a section in the store called the cutout bin. And the cutout bin is like when labels drop a band and are no longer pushing this material, but they pressed up a shitload of records. And they just put like a paper punch in there. They put a notch in the thing, and then it's like 99 cents. And I would just go through there and buy all these bands, the 99 cents bands, based on, because, you know, they're getting no promotion. You don't hear them from a friend. And you just go, that's a cool amp. That's a cool curly cord. That's a cool curly cable coming out of a Vox amp and a Telecaster laying on the ground. And it's like, that looks pretty cool. And I'd buy the record just on those like surface sort of, I think this is gonna be my bag, baby. And you know, and I'd find these really cool punk artists and like English bands and things that I dug. And you know, so when I'm nailing it and you don't understand, I'll wait for you to know Malcolm and all the rest of us. All right. Here's one by a fellow August 25th Virgo. It was a long shot. I should get back to Jeffrey Gaines' songs. That's what you came for. All right. That's it. What do you tell? myself, I know. What do you want to hear?
I like you.
Truest thing I ever put down. I mean, yeah, it's just like so cool to be in a relationship where their expectations aren't unrealistic. Like it's hard to be of sound mind and accept the engagement of a relationship that is clearly, obviously, has its limits. But again, in the effort to not waste a weekend or a summer, be like, listen, Jeff, you're not gonna be this, or this, or that. But here's the deal, I'm free, you're free, and I feel like I want to utilize you at the skill set you really are proficient in. And it's all right. When you leave in the morning and think you're sly and sneaking out, I kind of don't want you here in the morning anyway. So this is so perfect for the both of us. You come and you go. so good. I can get down to work. I can, you know, I can take a, I can take a business call without you walking into my Zoom. You know, I don't want to have to explain you at the office. But I'm not going to do without you in the night. And you're not going to kill a spider for me. And you're not going to go to Home Depot or Lowe's and help me get ducky stencils for the kitchen. I know you're not my man, but shit, get over it. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna miss it. And I like yous like that because, you know, I know a lot of people at the time when I wrote that, I was like, I knew a lot of people who were in love, but literally wanted to spend time with someone else. They loved that person and they didn't want to lose that the time they put in. They kind of like, I found that people were in love, not with the person any longer, but they were in love with the investment that they'd spent. They were in love with the identity of that person. They were in love with, all their friends knew them as a couple. And I spent 10 years on this dude. I'm not giving him up now, but Jesus Christ, I want to stick an ice pick in his arm. So they were together, but they really weren't about like real pure everyday new sheet of paper, every day facing the morning, the reality, and assessing, do I not just love you, feel for you, but like you? I like you that you, Jeff, you're just keeping it effing honest. There's no deception. We have our thing. And you know, it's so cool. So I like you, to me at that time, was the higher gift to give someone than telling them that I love you. So that's why I literally meant I like you. And you know, sometimes people are like, oh, well, that song's not deep enough. But like, I think I, in a sense, surpassed, I went searching for deep, only to come out the other side of it and realize it was back to the pure, the childlike innocence and truth of, you know, I like you is probably better, you know, at least in my case at that time. And so it was a real testament to a real thing. I don't know. Sometimes I think maybe the audience missed that part. I'm changing musically so quick. And since nothing really put me at the top 10, you know, like if I was somebody who had like a hit song, I'd probably stick with the method. But, you know, I put records out and they, you know, some people get them and they're real kind of click and like real secret. And I'm like, with that kind of secret, it's like I'm not doing the record company that much business that they lock me into a kind of sound. You know, it's like, well, you can, you know what? Each record, they're like, you can do whatever the hell you want. You don't cost as much. And we're usually very proud of what you've done. And we usually have like somebody like Wilson Phillips to make us our money. You know, we usually, like, we have some other band who's like gonna make us a shitload. I got signed to a label and got a great advance because Vanilla Ice, I was on a label with Vanilla Ice, and he made that label so much money, they were like, here you go. Go make a record. We don't care. In fact, what we hope is that the critics love it. It doesn't matter if anybody buys it. You're giving us critical acclaim because we're taking it on the chin because we got this guy. So if you could balance us out with a critically acclaimed record that we don't care if you sell any. And it happened to me again. I got on another label that paid for my record because they signed and had money coming in from the Who Let the Dogs Out. Which again, they're like, you know, look at, we're not gonna slit our own throats or whatever. We're gonna yeah, that's our song making us buying this office space. That's our song, but we hope the hell you make one that the critics love. And sales, you'll do whatever, you do what you want, you know? And I'm like, you know, you get in a rental car, you drive around places, you sing to people. You need any more? And I'm like, I would always try and go, I need a band. I'd like to get a string section. They're like, you know what? Just go into the in-store, stand in the corner, buy your record, sing at lunch. People will stop, they'll buy the record. That'll be a good day. And I'm like, okay. I thought we'd do a little more. They're like, no, don't hurt yourself. Just you and the guitar. That's it. That's all you need. And then I hear from the professionals in the record business industry, they would tell me, they go, you're your best salesman. And I'm like, no, I'm horrible at sales. Come on, do some stuff. And they'd be like, no, you just go busk on the street. And I'm like, no one's gonna stop. I've got really mellow stuff. There's no fire. with all that freedom, all that rope to do what I want. I want to thank you guys for allowing me. Thank you for letting me be myself again, as the song goes. Woo. Thanks so much. Give it up to all the music that you heard tonight.
Yeah.
And thanks Factory Records for having us. You know, I could do this all night, but I'm sure you guys have lives and weekends to get to. If you feel like it, if you feel like more voyeuristic fun, like and follow Jeffrey G Music on Instagram. Sexy pictures. Not always office awesome. So look in privacy. I'm pushing the envelope. But it's an interesting ride through my experiences. A lot of road shots and stuff like that, and little gig announcements. Probably won't follow back, but then, and when I, like, here's the thing though, I probably won't follow back, but you guys are well-adjusted people who don't get caught up in stuff like numbers. You don't make your esteem from how many people you have, because you have rich lives, quality lives, but give me all that sort of superficiality, because you're literally keeping me afloat. So like the page and you don't even have to come back to it. I sit there and I just look at the numbers grow. But like I said, you got enough love in your lives, so you don't. I won't follow you back, because you know what? So many pictures of like your grandchildren. I don't know, from babies. I guess it's cute. I guess it's all right. Call me when he can play drums. He's too little right now, and I'm just thumbing through. Sometimes I like people's flowers. I do like a lot of people's pages. I do like their gardens for some reason. I like gardens. And I like when you go on like natural vacations, when you go like hiking in the woods and shit. I kind of think that's neat. I'm not gonna do it, but I mean, like that kayak thing and some sort of Alaskan beautiful pass of water and mountains. I'm like, fuck yeah, I can. But I'm like I'm very liberal with the thumb and the like button. So if you see me popping up, I'm not gonna ever slip into your DMs. I don't want anything. But I do want to encourage all the awesome things that I see you doing. You know, a nice meal in a nice restaurant or something. I'm like, ooh. And I probably won't be oohing on over the food, but I'll probably be digging like the place setting. You know what I mean? Like if you've got like nice, you know, I like that. I like a Martha Stewart table, like a very crisp together setting. If you put stuff on paper plates, I'll skip. I'll never come back. If you have a holiday on paper plates, I get it, but I can't come back. Because I think, you know, everything we do deserves a flourish. And the best place you can do that for yourself is to set an awesome looking table. And then, like, you know, everything tastes better. It's hard to count on anything, 'cause no one knows just what tomorrow brings. Still here we are, we've shared so many years. We've come this far, there ain't nothing to fear. You will see, you and me will always be.
Every day I love you more, but you
Thank you. I do count it. That was wonderful. Thank you so much. And an encore would happen now. When I feel I've taken so much of your time, I really feel like
Make it.
All right. I really feel like it's really it's me. So much me. So much me right now.
That can never be too much.
No, I'm thinking, you know what I'm thinking about mostly? I'm thinking about who's making love to your old lady while you was out making love. That's what I'm thinking about. I'm telling you, man, I'm here out here rocking and rolling and sexing it up with you guys. And you know, I think the people I know at home love when I have a gig. You know, you go back to your place and everything's a little different. I'm like, I don't wear that. I don't think I wear it. I don't think that's a perfume I own. I don't have no fucking axe. I ain't got no axe sex machine. What's that axe sex machine? All around the soft materials in this house. I don't wear that. Who was here? And then you just gotta play it off like, well, yeah, I do leave you alone on Saturday night quite a lot. It's a lot to ask. So. I was gathering all the things I had to tell you. And found that there were more things I had to hide. Like lovers in tears, doubts and fears inside me. Cause when you're away, I've nothing to say. Cause when you're not here, love disappears. I was dreaming of the last time we lied together. Seems whenever need you, you're across the sea. Pressured by peers, sometimes it appears you don't want me. Yeah. Cause when you're away, I've not much to say. Yeah. Love disappears.
Now when you see
Jackson Brown or something, he's got a guy that runs him on a new guitar. All tuned up to the next song, and he knows he's gonna have to drop tuning, change it all up. Has a guy that's got it ready, he runs it out to him. So we gotta sell more records, people. Come on, I need a guy. I need a guitar guy. Thanks, Factory, for having some of the inventory out there in the lobby. Yeah. I've signed a few. That's very sweet. Thanks for spending some time.